We're going to talk about the advantage of having your data in tables. In this range of data, it's quite easy just to make a table by clicking somewhere within the range, going to the Insert tab, and then clicking Table. And it will ask you if the data that it selected is what the table you want, and it looks good to me, so I'm going to say OK. So instantly when your data is in a table, you have a drop-down list here for every filtering thing, so you can filter anything you like. Now, once your data is in the table, you can also right-click these headings, and you have more options that are coming up to you. So you have insert another column, delete the column, select the column or the entire table, clear contents, and then you have sort, and you have filter, and then you have table, and you can convert to a range or alternate text. Okay. Now, also, once you're in a table, you have the table tool designs comes up here. And the other advantage also is you can also grab, this is like a selected area, so you can grab and drag it over if you wanted to add another column, and it would put another column and another drop down there. So I'm going to undo that because I don't want another column right now. And on my table tools, I'm going to go. And if you notice here, it says header row, banded row, so that's the color scheme here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go put a total row here. And by default, it puts total at the left-hand side of your page, and it counts the number of records you have. And so now you have many options here. So if you click here, you have a drop-down, and now you have a range of things that you can do with this. You can do an average, you can count, you can do a minimum, maximum. So let's do an average. And for the next one, we can do, let's do maximum. So, like I say, there is many advantages here to using a table. Please subscribe.